Hello, I'm Gavin Hoey and you're watching another Photoshop tutorial. This week I'm going to show you how you can add some scotch tape, sellotape onto your grungy images. Now I know what you're thinking. You're thinking we're probably going to go into Photoshop because that's what we normally do, right? Well, not this week. I mean, we will get to Photoshop, don't worry. But rather than trying to make tape inside of Photoshop, there's a much easier and much better way of doing it. Now this involves a little bit of work. What you need to do is get yourself some tape. Not too difficult, that one. I bet you've just got some of that lying around the house, no problem at all. You also need a piece of black card. Very important little bit of equipment, this one, a bit of black card. Come on to that in a second. Let's first of all get the tape, take a length of this tape off, and like so. Now, we've got to get our tape from this nice, clean, pristine condition into something that looks a lot more grungy. So what we're going to do is just grunge this up a little bit by scrunching it all together, like that. Okay, really, really scrunch it up tight. Then pull it apart. Now it does help not to let go of the ends, of course, that's rather useful. We'll do that a couple of times because you can never have it too grungy, can you? Look at that. Lovely. Now, once you've got your tape looking all kind of a bit worn, a bit tatty, a little bit grungy, that's where the piece of black paper comes in. Now anything black will do, just stick your bit of tape onto the piece of paper, like that, and press it down. Don't press it too firmly, you want a few little ridges and bumps, you want this to look a little bit rough. Once you've got it on your piece of paper, you're ready to photograph it. So grab yourself your camera. I'm just going to use my little compact camera here. This is absolutely ideal. You can use an SLR if you like. But I like this one because it's got a macro function, which I'm just going to turn on so we can get a nice close-up shot of this bit of tape. So, put the tape. Normally we'd put the tape somewhere where the lighting is nice and even and soft, like an outdoor shot on a nice cloudy day. Bit bright the lights here, but they'll do for now. Let's just get a picture of this, get it in close, and there we go. So that's it. Simple as that. We've made our grunge tape, we've photographed our grunge tape, so what we're going to do now is to take this picture from the camera and put it onto the computer and play around inside of Photoshop. Okay, so here's a picture of the tape on the card, and as you can see, the picture is okay, but that black piece of card has actually turned grey. That's absolutely normal. That's what camera meters tend to do. So we're going to improve this by making the background black, and it is so important that it is black. I mean, really, don't miss that step out. So let's go for image, adjustment, and levels. And we could make a pure black by moving this black slider in. Instead, I'm going to get this little black icon here. This is the black eyedropper tool. Click on that and then click on an area where you want your picture to be black, like there, for example, and it'll change the look of the histogram and the whole thing will get darker. Now, if your tape's looking a little bit grey still, you can just bring it in a little bit by moving the white slider in, but I'm happy with it as it was. That's fine. Now, it's still not pure black all the way around, and I really can't emphasize enough how this has to be on a pure black background. So I'm going to get the crop tool. I'm going to get rid of the bits I don't actually need, because I don't need all of that background. Something like that. Lovely, and we'll crop that down. And then I'm going to change tools to the burn tool. I'm going to make sure that the range is set to shadows and exposure is pumped up all the way up to 100%. And then I'm going to burn the dark areas down, so the shadows, the dark parts of the picture. So I'm darkening down around the edge of the scotch tape. Now I don't have to worry about being desperately accurate here. I can go over the edges because this tool will only affect the dark areas, the shadows. So these lighter areas where the tape is, they're not going to get affected too much. Something like that. Now once you've got this against a pure black background, you can select it all, go to edit and copy, and then paste it onto a grungy picture of your choice. So I've got this one here. Now, I've already made a grungy picture. Now, you can use this tape effect in any picture you like, but it really lends itself well to this kind of grungy look. So let's go up to Edit and choose Paste, and that'll paste in our bit of tape, and then we're going to resize this using Edit and Free Transform. We'll just spin it around a little bit, something like that, and maybe shrink it down a little bit and push it over to the top right corner. I'd like to tape on the corners of this image, something like that. Okay, now, when you're happy, maybe just a bit smaller, click the tick, like that. Now, that's put the tape on, but have a look up close. I mean, it really doesn't look that convincing. That black border that we spent ages making looks totally wrong. But here's the trick. The reason I was so insistent on having a pure black border is because we're going to change the blend mode. Now, currently the blend mode is set to normal, but if I change it to screen, screen blend mode has a magic property on anything that's pure black. It makes it transparent. So no complicated selections required, no clever semi-transparent images. Just work on a pure black background, set the blend mode to screen, and all your problems are done for you. So here we go. We can now work on this a little bit tighter. Let's select the image below, and we'll get the polygonal, or is it polygonal? Depends where in the world you live, I guess. The polygonal lasso tool, and we'll just draw a little selection underneath the tape, because if this really was stuck onto this photograph, where it was stuck on, it would likely be a little bit brighter than the rest of the picture. So I can then come back to image, adjustment and levels, and just slide that mid slider up a little bit just to make the whole picture a little brighter where the tape is, like that. Select and deselect. Okay, let's fit that onto the screen. And there it is. So we now have our new tape in position. Now, if you want to enhance the tape still further, if you want to make your tape a bit brighter, simply copy the layer, make a duplicate of the layer, and that'll make that tape look a lot brighter indeed. Of course, if you've got a copy, you can always move that around, so I could put tape over the other corner as well, something like that, to have as many bits of sellotape as I want on the image. Okay, so there we go. There's how you can turn a piece of ordinary household tape into a grungy image element.